Good afternoon. Welcome to RCI's Navshikhar channel. I welcome our viewers to our show today. Our topic of discussion for today is ankle foot orthosis. And to discuss with us on this topic, we have with us our experts, Mr. Vijay Gulati and Dr. N.U. Manohar. Sir is a senior prosthetic and orthotics in the department and he is a consultant with PMR Safdarjung Hospital. Thank you so much for joining us. Now, before we move on with the discussion, I would like to give a brief introduction of what the AFOs actually are. They are basically orthoses or braces which are usually in plastic, which is put at the ankle and which supports the part below the knee. So this is what we'll be discussing about today, how it's fixed up, the whole procedure involving it and various FAQs relating to this. So we'll move on with our discussion now. First, I would just like to know, what exactly does an AFO mean?
Actually, AFO is an appliance for the physically disabled persons and the deformity below the knee. There are so many deformities at the ankle and due to different causes, maybe you can see the case of polio cases and cerebral palsy cases, hemiplegia, paraplegia and even quadriplegic cases are there, and all paralytic cases due to imbalance of muscles are there. And deformities by birth, that is congenital deformities. So for all these things, for prevention, correction and to support the deformed part of the body, so the AFOs are normally used.
So that means the AFOs are normally used for the correction of deformities and for supporting the lower part of the limb, of the leg. So that is why it is used. So what can be the various causes that would result in the fixing of an AFO?
Causes, actually previously we used to get all polio cases, poliomyelitis, PPRP, post paralytic polio, and now after this drive, actually polio action drive, the polio cases now is almost it's, you can say, zero. So now the cases normally you will get is cerebral palsy cases. The latest trend is most of the cases we are getting cerebral palsy cases, and in this also there is muscle power is there, but the body is not accepting the command of the mind. So due to that, there are imbalance of the extremity and the patient develops deformities, for which you need for prevention and correction and to make the patient to walk with that ambulatory.
There are many other indications that we need to support ankle and foot. The basic principle of orthosis, if we talk about the orthosis, then the basic principle is that we try to maintain our human body to the normal. If there is any abnormality due to any imbalance of muscle, loss of muscle, loss of motor system, due to any deformity, due to any disease, then the orthosis we provide to the patient to maintain a normal position. We come very close to the normal position of the body with the appliances, out of which one is the ankle foot orthosis, that we are going to talk about it, that ankle foot orthosis is base, because the foot and ankle is base of our standing. If we want to stand on it, everyone walks in it, stand on it. There are plenty of movements on this that we have to check all the movements. We have to control them. If there's any instability, then we have to provide a stability by giving an orthosis. So there are many indications, many reasons, many causes that we need to provide an AFO. So this is one of the topics, but it's a very important thing that we need to do it. This may be on a one side, maybe on the both the sides. So there are many indications, like Mr. Manohar has mentioned. So we have got many other, we have got our slides also.
So we'll move on with the
actually the common deformity actually that is foot drop. It's very common deformity. And even due to the gravitational force, the patient develops for this deformity if there is imbalance of muscles at the ankle. So causes may be any cause.
So that means basically in case there is anything that's a deviation from the normal walking style or the normal behavior, then we use an orthosis, that is the ankle foot orthosis, so that it can be, the person can have a normal gait as per the normal lifestyle.
Yes.
So we'll move on with the presentation now.
Yes, we can have one first slide.
Yeah. So basically ankle foot orthosis is the part which is used below the foot area. And as we now,
this is foot and the ankle, yeah, that we have to use it. So this is an orthosis.
So we'll discuss the indications now, the indications that are there with the ankle foot orthosis.
So these are the indications, say, like Mr. Manohar has mentioned, the thing is the foot drop. Foot drop means the forefoot of the foot that doesn't maintain the position of the uphold. That goes down, as you can see in the slide itself, the foot is going downward due to some gravitational attraction force and also because of the weakness of the extensor muscles. So these are the foot drop is the basic that visually one can see, that easily one can see that this is a foot drop, person is walking, because our walking cycle is when we walk, then how do we walk? We have got a cycle, like we put a heel first, then foot is flat, then we stand straight and then toe break and then toe off. These are the very synchronized movements of our body that we perform during our walking. But in this case, if there's a foot drop, then what does it happen? It means the first foot touches the ground, forefoot touches the ground instead of heel. So that is not a normal. What do we need? We need a heel to be touched first to the ground. Then we want that foot should be flat on the ground, then person has to stand on it, then walk with the toe break and toe off. So we have to come to the normal movements of the foot. So in case of foot drop, we need to do some orthosis that has to be given. We have to give an ankle foot orthosis to maintain the foot in a 90 degree and somewhere little bit in a dorsiflexion, so that a person when is walking, then he should walk with a heel strike, foot flat, toe break and toe off. Then this is the sequence that we never know about it. But only the thing, we don't feel it, but it happens like that in on each and every step of our walking cycle. So this is the cycle, that this is one of the cause, that is the foot drop.
So that means basically foot drop refers to, in a normal gait, it's the heel strike which has to happen first, but in case of a foot drop, the front portion, the forefoot touches the ground first, which should not be the case. So therefore we use an orthosis, yes, so that the heel strike touches the ground first.
Yes. And there's another thing, that if forefoot touches the ground, it means the person may drag the foot, may fall down, because this is not the, because in, he may have the problem in the clearing the ground, because we've got a very nice walking cycle in our the God has given us. This is very nicely, that even a small stone or anything obstacle on the ground, if you feel, then your foot feels that there is something different at the ground. But if the forefoot is on the ground, then it means there's a hardly little gap between ground and the foot to clear it. So person may fall down with that. So we need to do it, and the walking pattern almost that changes if foot drop is there. So we need to go for it, AFO for that.
So that means an AFO is required so that the heel strike touches the ground first.
Yeah.
So that was one of the first indications of where an ankle foot orthosis is used. Yes. We'll see the second indication now. That is a tight
TA tightness is actually for a longer period the affected foot remains in a faulty posture. So the patient develops tightness, means the active muscles pulls to their side and the paralytic muscles remain stretched actually. So for a longer period means, for example, if the patient is sleeping and while sleeping the patient, that time actually that relaxing position during night is 7 to 8 hours. So during the 7 to 8 hours the foot remains in that faulty posture only, and due to that the patient develops TA tightness. So once the day he develops a TA tightness, to stretch it to a normal position is sometimes it's not possible. Sometimes the patient has a fixed deformity if it is in that position for a longer period. Then the case has to refer for again for surgical correction and for the exercise therapy. Then after that, the patient will come for the AFO to maintain the correction achieved by surgery as well as exercise therapy.
So this is one of the causes most commonly being seen in the CP children in cerebral palsy cases, and the even hemiplegic cases also or paraplegic cases also, who they don't care for it. If the care is not being taken, like Manosa has said, the foot remains in a in the plantar flexion position, a foot drop position for a long time. So it remains over there, muscles become tight over there. So tightness of tendo achilles, TA is the tendo achilles, which is the tendon on our posterior side of the foot, which you can see in the slide also. The child is standing on the toe and heel is off, heel is not touching the ground. So the tendon is tight over there, and that's why then we need to there. Only that AFO can be given if it is stretchable to the 90 degree at least. If it is not stretchable, then it has to be referred to the surgical department for a surgery to lengthening of the TA, and then the exercise, the physiotherapy department, because the rehabilitation itself is a vast field and we have got many experts in this. So rehabilitation people, the physical, those physiotherapists, they give the exercise, the program for exercise, stretching exercise. So after the stretching, once it comes to the 90 degree at least, minimum 90 degrees required, then we can fit the AFO. And AFO has to be used for a long time along with the exercise continuously. Then patient can, because the minimum requirement of our standing is that foot should be on the ground and our leg should be 90 degree on it. Then only we can stand perfectly. So no one can stand on the toes. It's very difficult to stand. Even for us also, it's very difficult to stand on toes. We can't balance ourselves. So this TA tightness, if it is stretchable, then only we can give an AFO. If it is not stretchable, then we have to refer that case for the surgical and for the therapy department to bring down the ankle and foot to the 90 degree. So this is the another indication in that case.
So that means the second indication is the TA tightness, and this an AFO can be used in this case only if the TA tightness is stretchable. Only in that case an AFO can be used, so as to bring the foot and the leg to a 90 degrees angle, so that there can be a normal posture. And with the help of an AFO as well as various exercises, the person can have a normal gait, a normal walking style also. So that was the second indication. We move on to the third indication now. Third one, cerebral palsy. And we'll discuss about this.
Yeah. The cerebral palsy, you can see the slide, that cerebral palsy child, they have got a, they don't have balance on the muscular balance on the bone or on our structure. So foot becomes a... deformities are there. You can see the foot is break on the midfoot is break over there. The medial part is aspect is going to the valgus deformity. So there are so many deformities developed. It's only because of the imbalance. Why it is imbalance? Because the brain, which is our main source of our communication and our control of our body, that is being affected. Cerebral palsy is the paralysis in the cerebral. So it's a some part of it. It depends on patient to patient. Somewhere it is severe, somewhere it is mild, somewhere it is moderate. So it depends how much severity is there. According to that, the child is affected. This is this is not disease. This is a condition. Cerebral palsy is a condition of the person or a patient. Usually it is by birth. It is by birth. Cerebral palsy is there during the birth. Either it is pre-native, it is before the birth, or it is during the native. There is some problem at the time of delivery of the child, or post-native also. Sometimes it is
during because pregnancy. Of,
during pregnancy, that is the pre-native, and it may occur. This is something has been wrong with the, or after the birth, immediately after the birth, child starts crying, means inhaling the oxygen as much as possible. But if the child doesn't cry, it means the child run deficiency of the oxygen in the brain. So brain gets damaged at that time. If child doesn't cry at that time. So that is the more important. You must have noticed that if the child is not crying, then they used to slap the child also. So it has to be done.
So how exactly will an AFO help in the correction?
Yes, if you can see the slide. See, this is only the thing that if it is...
Actually, in this what happens, due to the body is not accepting the command of the brain actually, then the patient develops faulty postures, starting from hip, then knee, the foot is in plantar flexion, the knee is in flexion, the hip is in flexion, and that remains in like that only, and due to that the weight bearing falls anterior to the body, and that's why the patient, there are chances of falling down while walking, and there is no balance at all. And just to, if the deformity is at the ankle, there is coordination between ankle, knee and hip. And if you keep the ankle stable, the knee is also stable, then the hip joint is also stable. So the difference is also. So first you have to stable the ankle joints. So the AFO works effectively to stabilize the ankle joint actually.
So basically, in case of cerebral palsy, what happens is that the brain's instructions are not being followed by the foot or the leg or the limbs, and therefore with the help of an AFO, we can correct the ankle posture, the ankle posture, which will in turn, it will help in the proper posture of the knee and thereby the hip also. So therefore, the whole leg's posture can be correct, and that can be a more normal posture then. So that's how it's done in case of cerebral palsy. We'll move on to the next.
In normal weight bearing, the total weight bearing of the body, 40% of the weight is borne by the heel itself, and 20% is borne by the first great toe metatarsal head, and 10 each by the remaining toes actually. So this is the total weight bearing. And once the heel is raised, and the total weight is borne by the toes itself, so the complete weight is borne by the metatarsal heads. So, if it is for a longer duration, then the patient will get develop pain at the toes level, and he is unable to walk, he is unable to keep the foot in a proper position. So, these problems are there.
So, in cerebral palsy, means the child starts standing late, not on the milestones are not in a proper way, these are delayed, and in some of the cases in cerebral palsy, we used to give an AFO just to maintain a proper position, maintain a normal position of the foot. Not necessary that we give an AFO for a walking purpose itself. Initially, till the child starts standing, because the child, they develop the balance of the body very late. Sometimes at 1 year, sometimes it's 1.5 years, sometimes it's 2 years, maybe 3 years also, maybe 4 years also. So till that time, if we don't care for ankle and foot, that by the time, as we have seen earlier, the spasticity or the tightness of the TA that makes the child into the fixed deformity of the foot into plantar flexion. To avoid that circumstances that we should not go for a surgery, then we have to take precaution right from the beginning, so that foot should be maintained in a 90 degree at least, that is which is required for the standing. So child will may stand at 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 year, whenever the child is ready for that, at that time the foot should be in a 90 degree. So we have to give an AFO just for the maintenance, and AFOs are also being used for the correction also. If there is any tightness or something, we can give a release to the tight muscles also by giving an AFO in the case of cerebral palsy cases.
So that means an AFO can be used to correct the faulty positions also. Yes. And a very important thing that he just told us, that it's very important for the early intervention and for the early decision of getting an AFO put, because to avoid unavoidable circumstances later on, to avoid these surgical circumstances, yes, we should get an AFO put as soon as it's discovered. Yes. So we move on to the next indication now. That is Parkinson's disease. So we'll just discuss about this.
Parkinson's disease is a, then at the age we get the disease, which again makes the patient that instability to the lower part of the body. So patient is not stable on the legs, so it makes a shaky movement, foot goes to the plantar flexion, foot drop goes over there. So in this case also, we need to keep the foot in 90 degree, so that at least minimum patient should have 90 degree position for the standing which we need. There may be a difficulty in the walking itself, but only with AFO, with the help of an ankle foot orthosis, patient can be helped to maintain a proper position, and for that it is then AFO is required. This is a one of the reason itself. Similarly, there is a multiple sclerosis. That is also means the foot is not getting the command from the brain. That is also sometime maybe younger age also. If there is no command on this, then forefoot tends to drop. Means foot drop will be there. To maintain a proper position, we can't work on that. The command should come back. Only the thing, because that is being affected. So if there is no command, then only we have to work on a forefoot to maintain it in a 90 degree so that patient should have a normal walking or a smooth walking during the walking cycle and the his or her working is normal. So we in this disease also, the forefoot goes to the foot drop. So basically it comes to the foot drop, either maybe because of Parkinson's disease or maybe multiple sclerosis, or maybe because of hemiparesis or paraplegia. All the diseases or deformities are the finally the foot goes to the ground. That is the foot drop is there basically. So this is another one of them. So
what exactly is muscular dystrophy?
Sclerosis. One is the sclerosis, then is a muscular dystrophy. This is the another cause. Muscular dystrophy is usually at the age of, it is being noticed at the age of 7 or 8.
Normally muscular dystrophy, that is gradual weakening of the muscles. Day by day the muscles are decreasing, then and there won't be any function in that. So it will affect to the whole body then. It comes first to the lower extremity, then it comes to the upper extremity, then even that affects to the total body.
So this is the disease, this is the deformity which is...
This is progressing disease.
Progressive. And this comes into the notice at the age of 6, 7 years or 8 years of the age of the child. When the child is not able to stand from the ground or from the squatting position, the child will not be able to stand up. Or while climbing the stairs, then on the stairs he may have the difficulty. He needs some support for the climbing the stairs. So in that case also, so that is a symptom that child is running through the muscular dystrophy. One has to go for the checkup, and if it is confirmed, then we have to maintain the lower extremity by giving an ankle foot orthosis to keep the ankle and foot into normal position as much as we can do, because it's a progressive disease. It can progress, it will progress. So only the thing we have to work on a just to maintain a proper position of the body, so that child up to the age, whatever the age of the child is, then foot should be in a 90 degree position. It, as Manoj Saab said, it affects whole body, not only the foot and the lower limb, it affects the upper extremity as well, because the patient, the child will not be able to hold the things also with the hands also. So it's a progressive disease, it keeps on progressing, and results are not so fruitful in this. Only we have to prevent the deformity, we have to prevent the deformity due to this disease itself.
So that means this is an example of a progressive deformity, and with age and with time it keeps on progressing, and basically what is required is to have a 90 degree angle between the foot and the leg. So that is what is required most, and in order to correct that angle and to bring it to a 90 degree angle, we use an AFO in order to reduce the progression and to reduce the extent of deformity that can be caused by this.
For example, if you don't maintain the foot in 90 degree, then the chances is actually, if the foot is in plantar flexion, if there is foot drop, then there are chances of getting hyperextension at knee due to the foot drop actually. If the foot is in dorsiflexion, then there are chances of getting buckling of the knee. So there is coordination between the ankle as well as the knee as well as the hip also. So the due to the muscle weakness. So that's why it is very important to stabilize the ankle first. So if he wants to stabilize the ankle, then automatically stabilizes the knee, stabilizes the hip during locomotion.
So that means, as we just discussed, the ankle, the knee and the hip are all linked, interlinked, and if the ankle is not in the correct posture, not in the correct stable state, then automatically the knee and the hip will also be affected. So therefore it's very important to correct the posture and the stability of the ankle at the first step. So we move on to the next slide now, and that is the next indication, that is the post polio paralysis. So we'll just discuss about this.
So post polio paralysis, actually the bones are Good. There is no problem there. Only there is imbalance of the muscles are there. The muscles functioning are there. In some cases, you will get some muscle power in the muscles. And in some cases, the zero muscle power is there. In some cases, one group muscles are working. Another group muscles are not working. So this is actually the indication in the polio cases. There is sensation and there is other parts also where there is no problem. In the range of motion is also there is no restriction unless the patient develops contractures due to imbalance of the muscles. So if at the early stage, if you maintain the lower extremity, the limb in a proper positioning, so that is proper positioning also again you need a foot drop splint. If you draw splint, you can go for ankle foot orthosis to maintain the ankle in correct alignment. You can also go for knee ankle foot orthosis. That is for the whole limb to keep the limb in correct alignment. So that is during acute stage. And once the patients, the muscles are not recovering, the patient is already affected with polio. And to make the patient ambulatory also, again you need the lower extremity orthosis.
So like in polio, it is say the loss of muscle. Due to polio, there is a loss of muscles. Whereas in cerebral palsy, muscle power was there, only the command was not there. So brain was not able to control those muscles, not able to manage with those muscles. Whereas here, brain is alright, everything is fine, getting the command, but muscles are being paralyzed due to the virus, that you know the polio virus. Because nowadays, polio is vanishing. In our India, there is a very good work is being done by the government, by the NGOs, all together. They are working to eradicate the polio. Every month there is a program to give the polio doses. Polio happens at the age of 5, 6, not more than that. It's up to that age. That's why these polio drops are being given all the younger children which are below the 5 years or 6 years. So they should be prevented to get this disease because it's not curable disease. It cannot be cured. So it has a person, if it is being affected at the age of 5 or 6, the patient has to live rest of the life, maybe 50 years, 60 years, 70 years. That is with the weak muscles, with the no power.
So even the use of an AFO cannot...
AFO supports for walking, but muscle power cannot be... we can't bring back
patient the cannot muscle regain power. The muscle power.
Muscle power can't be regained. Only the thing, patient can walk with the orthosis. Orthosis becomes a part of their life. They have to use it for whole life. Even after we have the patients, they are... they used to come to us when they were in the school, but now they got married, they have children, but still they are using the paralysis.
So basically it's just a support, it can't not correct the whole
thing. Important to make the patient ambulatory.
This is a lifelong thing that they have to use it for that. So they have to depend on it. So that's why we want that it should be eradicated. The person should not be affected by polio. Prevention is much, much better than in this case. That if it is prevented at the age of 5-6 years, only a few drops has to be given. The child can be very in a good position throughout the life.
So mainly prevention is better than cure.
Yeah.
So in this, prevention is very much needed, and where there is a method of prevention is available in India, everything is there. So all the parents and the people, they should encourage the people for the polio drops also.
So by taking the polio drops, we can eradicate polio.
They won't be polio.
So therefore we see how important it is to take the polio vaccination, the polio drops, so as to eradicate this disease and deformity, because this is a lifelong thing. Even with the help of an AFO, the AFO can just support the limb, but the orthosis has to be there throughout the life, and the polio will remain for lifelong. So right now we're discussing various indications that are related with the ankle foot orthosis. We've just discussed a foot drop. Then we discussed cerebral palsy. We've also discussed post polio paralysis. And basically what we understood till now is that there has to be a 90 degree angle which has to be maintained between the foot and the leg so as to maintain a normal posture, and there has to be proper stability. So this is what we're discussing right now. We'll discuss more, but right now it's time for a short break. So we'll see after break.
The chief handicap of the blindness is not blindness, but the attitude of seeing people towards them. आइए जानने और समझने की कोशिश करते हैं कि बधिरांधता यानी डेफ ब्लाइंडनेस क्या है। बधिरांधता एक स्थिति है जिसमें दृष्टिहीनता एवं सुनने की शक्ति में कमी आती है तथा जिससे विचारों के आदान प्रदान और रोजमर्रा की आवश्यकताओं की पूर्ति में समस्या उत्पन्न होती है। बलराम एक 9 साल का बधिरांध बच्चा है। वो एक प्री मैच्योर बच्चा है जिसका शारीरिक विकास उसकी आयु के अनुरूप नहीं हुआ था। वो एक निम्न वर्गीय श्रेणी से संबंध रखता है तथा 5 साल से लगातार नेशनल एसोसिएशन फॉर ब्लाइंड दिल्ली के प्रशिक्षण कार्यक्रम से संलग्न है। इन 5 सालों के अंतर्गत उसे रोजमर्रा के कामों में, हलन चलन में, उसकी शैक्षणिक जरूरतों के अनुसार संप्रेषण द्वारा प्रशिक्षण दिया गया है जिससे वो इन सब क्रियाओं में स्वावलंबी बन सके। बलराम बिना किसी सहायता के चाकू से फलों को काट सकता है। उनके छिलकों को कूड़ेदान में डाल सकता है। अपने बर्तनों को खुद साफ कर सकता है। उन्हें सही जगह पर रख सकता है। सही बर्तनों का चयन करके खुद खाना खाता है। एवं पानी की बोतल निकालकर पानी भी पीता है। इन सभी क्रियाओं में वो टेक्चुअल साइन लैंग्वेज से निर्देशों को ग्रहण करता है और अपने भावों को व्यक्त करता है। टेलर फ्रेम और ब्रेलर द्वारा गणित, पठन लेखन में भी प्रशिक्षण प्राप्त कर रहा है। सभी बच्चों की तरह उसका भी एक मनपसंद खेल है। उसे सेलफोन को अपने कानों पर लगाकर उसका कंपन महसूस करना अच्छा लगता है। कहा जाता है, वॉकिंग विद अ फ्रेंड इन डार्क इज बेटर देन वॉकिंग अलोन इन लाइट। कहने का तात्पर्य है कि वो लॉन्ग केन ट्रेवल, टैक्टाइल पाथ, ट्रेलिंग और लैंडमार्क्स द्वारा हलन चलन में भी सक्षम है और व्यायाम संबंधी क्रियाएं जैसे ट्रेडमिल, स्टैटिक साइकिल का स्वचालन भी कर सकता है। कहा गया है, द बेस्ट एंड मोस्ट ब्यूटीफुल थिंग्स इन द वर्ल्ड कैन नॉट बी सीन और इवन टच्ड, दे मस्ट बी फेल्ट विद द हार्ट।
Welcome back after the break. Our topic discussion for today is ankle foot orthosis. And before the break, we were discussing the various indications of the ankle foot orthosis. We'll continue with the discussion. And the next indication is hemiparalysis. So we'll just discuss as to what it really means.
So hemiparalysis is that this is paralysis of one side of the body, because it how it happens, this is because of the injury to the brain. Either it's due to injury to the brain, or this is due to the stroke. If there's a high blood pressure and there's a stroke to the patient, and then attacked with the blockage that is the in the brain. If there's a no blood supply or there's a clot in the brain, then the part, if right side of the brain is affected, then left side of the body will be paralyzed. If the left side of the brain is affected, then right side of the body will be paralyzed. So this is on a one side. So immediately after the attack, it's very difficult to see remove the clot, but there are now techniques are there that try to remove the clot also. But if there's an injury due to any external injury to the brain, due to an accident or any fell down or anything is there, then only it's a difficult. If part is and the brain is affected and one side is paralyzed, only the then we have to control the foot, lower limb as well as the upper limb also, because on the one side is also affected. Then lower side, that we have to give an AFO, which is the basic thing, initial thing that is to be given, and some physiotherapy part is there. The exercise are to be given. The person has to perform a physical exercise to maintain the proper body. For walking purpose, we need an AFO for that.
So that means in case of a hemiparalysis, what happens is that there might be a brain clot, a clot in the brain, and the concept says that if the clot is on the left side of the brain, the right side of the body is affected, paralyzed, affected, and if the clot is on the left side, the right side of the body, that is the opposite side of the body, gets affected of the side of the clot. So that is what hemiparalysis means. Then we have paraplegia, and what does this mean?
Paraplegia, actually it's a traumatic cases, all traumatic cases, and that is injury in the spine. Due to injury in the spine, the total lower extremity is paralyzed, both the legs are paralyzed, there is no sensation, and no ball bladder control is there. The patient is unable to stand, unable to walk.
Depending on the lesion of the...
So that depends actually. So during acute stage after the injury, the patient, there are chances of getting recovery from 6 to 8 weeks. So during that period, whatever normal recovery the patient can get, so they will get. And after the 8 weeks, then if there is no recovery, then the patient will go for exercise therapy. Then the patient will get some improvement in the muscle power. But the sensory loss also, in some cases, the patient gets partial sensory recovery there. In some cases, there is no recovery at all. The total, the whole body, the lower extremity is totally paralyzed, and the patient is wheelchair bounded, and he unable to walk independently, unable to stand. So wheelchair bound. Then other things are, then you can go for orthosis. The patient can stand with support. So for that, the patient needs an orthosis, lower extremity orthosis. So lower extremity, that depends on the effectiveness. If it is affected below the knee, then you can go for AFO. If it is affected above the knee, then you can go for KFO. If it is affected for the protective joint, then they have to go for HKFO. So these are the different stages. So this is for the both the legs, normally. In some patients, they get recovery in one leg, they won't get recovery in another leg. So these cases is also there. So the main is to make the patient erect in standing position, so for proper blood circulation, and to give him a psychological boost up so that he is standing erect. For that purpose, the orthosis plays an important role in that actually. So this is also for a lifelong, if one of the patient gets a paralysis, that is also a lifelong. The remaining life, the patient is normally wheelchair bounded.
As we have discussed, the previous one is the post-polio paralysis. It's entirely opposite to that. In a post-polio, there's a sensation is there. Person can feel if something is hurting or something is over there. But whereas in paraplegic or hemiplegic, the sensory loss is also there. The patient cannot feel any pain or any anything which is hurting the patient in the foot or the leg itself in the affected part. So in this case, we have to be very careful. Whatever the orthosis we are giving, it has to be visually, it has to be checked whether it is properly fitted or not, because patient is not going to give us a report that whether it is hurting or not, because he doesn't have any sensation. He doesn't have sensation of cold and hot also. So we have to be very careful while giving an ankle foot orthosis or any kind of orthosis to such type of the patient. in that case, because sensory loss is there.
So that means extreme care and precaution has to be undertaken before giving an AFO in such cases, because as we just discussed that the patient himself cannot discuss or disclose as to what effect or improvements are being there with the help of an AFO, because there is paralysis and he cannot feel anything. So therefore, it's only by visual sights that the doctors or the physiotherapists can see and decide as to what kind of an AFO is required and how it has to be used and how it's being effective in such cases.
And there is, paralysis or hemiplegia. Paraplegia is also sometimes it's very common in the cases of spina bifida. Spina bifida is a deformity which is by birth itself. The child is born with a bulge on the posterior side of the lumbar region itself. So if that bulge is there, that causes defect to the vertebrae in the vertebral column. There is a spinal cord. It affects the spinal cord. It means that from that part, the lower part is being affected, and there's no sensation to the child in the lower part itself. So there's no command, there's no connection of the spinal cord to the lower extremity. So in that case also there is a foot drop deformity, or that's the paraplegic condition itself. So that is the condition of the paraplegic also in the children case. So one is the accident, that is the traumatic injury is there. Yes. So in the case of injury means if there is any injury to the spinal cord or the vertebrae, our vertebras, so that causes the paraplegia, or sometimes it is due to the spina bifida in the children itself, by birth itself. So right from the birth, the children, they have to go for a therapy and exercise, and the appliances, orthotic appliances, AFO, KFO, all these has to be given to the such type of the children. They have to live whole life with the orthosis itself.
So that means even in this case, an AFO can only provide support, but this thing is lifelong. In case of a paraplegia, as we just discussed, there can be either an acute injury in the spinal cord or it can be congenital. So therefore, an AFO can be used just in order to support and correct the posture of the foot, ankle and the knee joint.
Yes, then if we need the knee support, then we have to go for a knee. From ankle foot orthosis, we have to give further support to knee ankle itself, foot, so that becomes a knee ankle foot orthosis. That will become a KFO.
Okay.
So in that case also, we have to add the knee support. If the knee is also affected, knee is not sufficient to hold the body, then we have to give a knee support also. So that becomes a knee ankle foot orthosis.
So this was about paraplegia. We'll go on to the next slide now, which is about the bilateral AFO.
Yeah. This is the use of an AFO. You can see the children that this child was earlier in the slide, it was without an orthosis. The foot was completely broken into the midway itself. The foot was in a valgus deformity. So with the support of ankle and foot orthosis, so in this case, you can see the child is standing at least with some support. Initially, to make him walk or stand, some support is required. Sometimes it doesn't require. It depends on child to child. If it is severe, then we need a support. If it's a mild, then child may not be requiring any support. So this is the thing that we have to give in a bilateral AFO, both the sides. Bilateral means we have to give an ankle foot orthosis on both the sides. In the child case, we give a AFO with the fixed ankle. There is no ankle movement at the foot. There is no ankle joint at the foot actually, but anatomically there is a movement. Slight movement is there for to make the child comfortable with that, and it is well supported, well padded with the particular straps. We'll discuss in further itself in other slides also. So this is a one of the case that you can see that fitted with an ankle foot orthosis to make a child stable standing over there.
So that means this is one of the first uses of an ankle foot orthosis, as we can just see over here in the slide, that this child is using an AFO, which is helping him in a stable standing position. The AFO has been fixed up at the ankle level and it is helping the child in standing straight and standing stably. So this was one of the first uses. We move on to the next use now, which is for again stable standing. We can see in the slide.
The other child, you can see, is standing without any support. The child is balancing himself on a bilateral AFOs. Both the sides AFOs are there, but is quite stable without any support. He's trying to make a balance, because we learn from ourselves itself. This is by nature itself. we make, if we are flat on the foot, then nature itself gives us an idea how to balance ourselves. So this child is trying again that both the sides, you can see the knee is slightly bended, but still the child is able to manage with the position
first,
actually, of the hands.
First after fitting an orthosis AFO, you will make the patient stand in a parallel bars. So that is standing balance will teach the patient first. So after the standing balance, then we'll ask the patient to walk in the parallel bar by holding the parallel bars. So that is second stage. After the parallel bars, then we'll bring the patient out of the parallel bars and the patient will walk with the help of walker. So that previous slide you have seen with our patient is standing with the walker and is walking with the walker. Then without walker, then the next stage is we'll make the patient walk with the help of crutches. So crutches, there are two types of crutches are there. One is elbow crutch is there, one is axillary crutch is there. So whichever is stable to the patient, according to our assessment, will give crutches to the patient. Then once the stage is also gone, you can give him a single stick also, sometimes for the balance point of view. Then you can make the patient without any support, walking without any support. So these are the different stages. Then after that stage, you have to also teach to the patient to walk on the ramp. Means climbing up and climbing down, only on the slopes actually. Then we'll also teach the patient to climb up the stairs by holding the railing. Then climbing down means coming down from the stairs. So these are the different stages we have to teach during trial of the AFOs actually. So once if you see the performance of the patient is good along with the AFO, then the final delivery of the AFO is given to the patient to the homebound activities.
So that means there can be various stages that we can see as the person moves, the patient moves along after putting in AFO. For example, as we saw in the previous slide, there was a person who had gotten AFO fixed and he was standing with the help of a support. And in the next slide, as we just saw, that the person has an AFO fixed, but he's standing without support. So therefore, as we can just see and as we just discussed, that a patient first has to go through various stages after getting an AFO put. He can first get to use parallel bars, and then he can get to use a walker, then he can move on to the crutches. So in the similar fashion, there are various stages which the patient has to undergo after getting an AFO put and in order to progress his stability and his posture.
And we are discussing now about the children itself with fitted with an AFO. So in the child case, certainly child is going to grow itself. The AFO will be short after few months or 1 year or so. Yeah. So this has to be changed from 1 year or 1.5 year depending on the individual growth of an individual child. Because sometimes child has got a fast growth. So they may come out of the AFOs very fast. So they need to be changed itself.
So how do we decide the duration of the changing?
They have to come for the review. Okay. After 4 months or 6 months, they have to come for review to the rehab professional. Either it's a prosthetist, orthotist, or it's a physiotherapist, or a consultant therapist. Whatever is there, or the doctor, they can go to wherever they have to. Or sometimes the parents are also this. Anyone can see that the foot is tight into the AFO. So AFO will remain in the same size, but foot will grow up. So it becomes tight. So we need to change it from time to time. The parents have come again after 1 year or 1.5 year. Then depending on the, initially we can lose it a little bit so that it can last for some more time. But at one stage we have to change the AFO also.
So that means this is a very important point that he's just put up, that the patient has to go for regular checkups and for regular review processes even after getting an AFO put, because as the child grows, the size of the foot might grow and the AFO might become smaller in size. So therefore, the AFO has to be of a fit size, and for that, the child has to go regularly for the reviews. So
3-4 months. In the period of 3-4 months.
Okay, so that means for approximately 3 to 6 months, the person can go for reviews, and as per the requirements, the AFO can be changed
or modified
per the requirements.
Yes.
So this was another use. We move on to the next use now. So these
you
are again
compare the child. The child is without an AFO and with the AFO. You can see that without an AFO, it's a he must be holding some object over there in the front or holding a hand of somebody else. And here itself, with the AFO, is standing straight, at least without any support. So he will learn within a few weeks or so, standing with the AFO. And certainly with the use of an AFO itself, the patient or the child feels comfortable because they are much balanced. We have got the report from the parents itself. So after the use of an AFO, after a few days or a few weeks, the patient or the child starts himself standing with the AFO and walking with an AFO, they feel more comfortable with that because they feel the child itself, the confidence comes into the child that what do we that? We have what a one once we stand with the support at the early age, what do we feel? Once we stand straight, we get the confidence that we are now able to stand itself. Then we start walking. So once the patient or the child gets the confidence of standing erect without any support, he can walk very fast.
So that means as we can just see in the slide, we can compare the two positions. In the right side, we have a child who is probably holding something or holding a support, holding a hand or some bar or something, some support for standing. And on the left side, we have another child who has got an AFO put up, and this AFO is helping him to stand stably by himself. So we can compare both the pictures and we can see that how the person will automatically gain confidence and be able to stand on his own, and there's definitely the psychological boost up and the confidence definitely rises up once he sees that he's able to manage on his own without any other support. So that is how an AFO helps us. So we'll move on to the next slide now. So these are the various types of AFOs which we will now discuss. The first one
is the ankle foot orthosis AFO with the initial dorsiflexion. Initial dorsiflexion means we keep the foot in a dorsiflexion, means slightly flexed position. In this you can see the posterior part is slightly forward. So how does it help? Where does it help? This is an AFO which in the case where we have some of the children due to the late intervention, only the thing we see that there's a tendency of the knee going backward. That is called hyperextension of the knee. So if knee goes backward, that is also an abnormal thing. That's not a normal thing. So what do we need? We need to push the knee forward to bring it back. So by keeping the AFO in 85 degrees, slightly in a dorsiflexion position, it helps the child to put a pressure on the calf muscles. We got the calf muscles over there to put a pressure on the calf muscles to push the knee forward to bring it to back to the at least 180 degree. So this AFO, it helps very nicely. We have seen very good results after the use of 6 months, 8 months or eight, 1 year, up to the 1 year. So it comes back. So the AFO with the 85 degree, it helps the child who is having a tendency or the there is an, a slightly hyperextension of the knee. It can be given to the patient to maintain the ankle and foot as well as the knee also. Without putting more efforts on the knee itself, with the AFO itself, we can control the knee as well.
Normally, at the ankle, there are two movements. One is plantarflexion, other one is dorsiflexion. Plantarflexion is the foot is in foot drop position. And dorsiflexion is the patient is taking weight on the heel and the toes are raised up. So these are the two movements. In normal walking, 5 to 10 degrees plantarflexion, 5 to 10 degrees dorsiflexion the patient normally takes during walking. And suppose there is deformity at the ankle, if the patient develops a foot drop, if there is an equinus deformity, so that time actually what happens, if the foot goes into plantarflexion, then the knee automatically goes into hyperextension. And if you control the plantarflexion, so by means of this AFO, and you can keep the ankle in 85 degree, means we are not allowing plantarflexion and the foot is maintained in 85 degree, means 5 degrees dorsiflexion. In other cases, normally in AFOs will keep the ankle in 90 degree, but in this case we are providing 5 degrees dorsiflexion and we are restricting completely the plantarflexion. So this forces the knee to remain in 5 degrees flexion. Thus, we are preventing hyperextension of the knee. So that is the advantage of 85 degree.
So that means this is the first type of AFO which we can just see, in which case, for example, in some cases what happens is the knee is bent slightly towards the outer side, which is not...
towards the
posterior side, which is not supposed to be so. And therefore, to prevent that from happening, to correct that from happening, we use an AFO with an 85 degrees angle, so that the knee comes in the dorsiflexion angle. So, so that is why we use an AFO with an 85 degrees angle, which is normally we use AFOs with 90 degrees angle. But in this case, since the knee is towards the posterior side, it is bent. So therefore, we use an AFO with an 85 degrees angle to correct that posture of the knee. So that was the first type of AFO. We move on to the next type of AFO now, which is fixed to the ankle with a 90 degrees angle. So we'll discuss about this one now.
So this is the basically most commonly being used ankle foot orthosis with the 90 degree, because this is the basic requirement or the minimum requirement that we need a leg or a shin part to the foot. It should be 90 degree for a correct standing or the erect standing of the person or the child. So we need an AFO, because this is the basic, even to maintain, if the child is not ready to stand, even then we have to maintain this minimum position of 90 degree, so that the child will be ready to stand after some few weeks or few months also. By that time, the ankle and foot will be straight and the patient will be able to stand on it. This 90 degree AFO is most commonly being used. And only the thing, some of the strapping and the positioning of the foot, that is being amended or altered as per the requirement of individual patient or individual child itself.
This type of design actually normally provide if the ankle muscles are zero, total zero. So there is no muscle power. The foot is neither the patient developed the foot drop nor the patient developed dorsiflexion deformity. So to maintain it actually, to keep the foot in neutral, that is 90 degree. So normally we'll provide 90 degree foot drop stop. So previously we discussed about 85 degree foot drop stop, and this is 90 degree foot drop stop. So we are not allowing any movement at the ankle. The ankle is fixed almost. It won't allow either the plantar flexion or the dorsiflexion. The foot is remained at 90 degree. It's stable in neutral position.
So, what kind of patients do we put up the 90 degrees angle AFO? In what kind of patients do we use this AFO?
Commonly, we'll provide for polio cases as well as paraplegic cases also.
Okay. So, this was the second type of AFO, that is having an AFO with a 90 degrees angle. And this AFO helps us to maintain a 90 degrees angle between the foot and the leg. And this can be used for patients with polio or for patients with paraplegia. So this was the second type. The first one that we discussed was with an 85 degrees angle. The next one that we just discussed is with a 90 degrees angle. So these are the various types of AFOs that we're discussing. We'll discuss more. We'll carry on with this discussion. But right now it's time for a short break. So we'll see you after the break.
The state of knowledge exists. The will, the capacity, and method are usually the problem. मानसिक मंदता एक ऐसी विकलांगता है जो 18 वर्ष की आयु से पूर्व कभी भी हो सकती है, जिसमें व्यवहार अनुकूलता में कमी एवं बुद्धि क्षमता 70% से कम होती है. Alone we can do so little. Together we can do so much. भारतीय पुनर्वास परिषद द्वारा देश भर में पंजीकृत केंद्र इस बात को प्रमाणित करते हैं. NIMH प्रादेशिक केंद्र नई दिल्ली एक ऐसा ही केंद्र है जहां छात्रों को प्रशिक्षण दिया जाता है. जिसके उपरांत वे मंद बुद्धि बच्चों की सेवा में नियुक्त होते हैं. क्लासरूम टीचिंग, ग्रुप टीचिंग, एवं भारतीय पुनर्वास परिषद के नव शिखर चैनल पर प्रसारित टेलीकॉन्फ्रेंसिस द्वारा संबंधित विषयों पर विस्तार पूर्वक ज्ञान दिया जाता है। मेडिकल, ऑक्यूपेशनल थेरेपी, फिजियोथेरेपी, स्पीच थेरेपी, साइकोलॉजी और स्पेशल एजुकेशन जैसे क्षेत्रों में छात्रों को प्रशिक्षित किया जाता है। प्रयोगात्मक अनुभव एवं अभ्यास के लिए टीचर ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम के उपरांत छात्रों को मंदबुद्धि बच्चों के साथ कक्षाओं में नियुक्त किया जाता है और इंडिविजुअलाइज्ड एजुकेशन प्लान का भी आधार बनाया जाता है, जिससे वे संपूर्ण शिक्षा एवं चिकित्सा शैली को समझ सकें। इस पूरे प्रशिक्षण कार्यक्रम के दौरान विद्यार्थी जर्नल्स, न्यूज़लेटर्स, पीरियोडिकल्स, चार्ट्स, मॉडल्स, कंप्यूटर ट्रेनिंग एवं टेक्स्ट बुक्स का उपयोग कर सकते हैं। कहते हैं, कीप योर फेस टू द सनशाइन एंड यू कैन नॉट सी द शेडो। इसी बात को ध्यान में रखते हुए विद्यार्थियों को सरकारी एवं गैर सरकारी संस्थाओं में नियुक्त किया जाता है, जहां वे मंदबुद्धि बच्चों के लिए निरीक्षण, प्रशिक्षण एवं अनुसंधान का दायित्व संभालते हैं और इसके पश्चात ये विद्यार्थी इस प्रशिक्षण का उपयोग मंदबुद्धि बच्चों के सामाजिक एवं शैक्षणिक उत्थान एवं विकास में करते हैं और एक लक्ष्य की ओर आगे बढ़ते हैं। और फिर लक्ष्य कितना ही दूर हो, फासला नजरों का धोखा भी तो हो सकता है, वो मिले या ना मिले हाथ बढ़ाकर देखो।
हम होंगे कामयाब, हम होंगे कामयाब, हम होंगे कामयाब एक दिन। ओ मन में है विश्वास, पूरा है विश्वास, हम होंगे कामयाब एक दिन। We shall overcome, we shall overcome, we shall overcome someday. Oh, give me my heart, I do believe that we shall overcome someday. We shall overcome someday. We shall overcome someday.
Welcome back after the break. Our topic of discussion for today is ankle foot orthosis. And before the break, we were discussing the various types of ankle foot orthosis that can be used in a person. We've just discussed two types. For example, we discussed the 85 degree angle AFO. Then we discussed the 90 degree angle AFO. Now we move on to the third type, which is the 95 degree angle AFO. So we'll just discuss about that one.
So like 85 or 90 degrees, we are also having one design that is known as 95 degree. 95 degrees means actually the foot is in 5 degrees plantar flexion. So up to now, the 90 degree means the foot is in neutral position. 85 degrees means the foot is in 5 degrees dorsiflexion. And 95 degrees means the foot is in 5 degrees plantar flexion. So if you keep the foot in 5 degrees plantar flexion, so this forces the knee to remain in extension. This won't allow easily the knee flexion. Thus, we are maintaining the knee in stable position. So that actually works when if the muscles are muscle group at the knee, if one group is paralyzed, for example, the knee extensors are paralyzed, those muscle group are known as quadriceps. The quadriceps are weak and the hamstrings are powerful. And that time what happens, the hamstrings will pull the knee into flexion. So while standing, the knee patient normally gets buckled and is unable to stand. And if you want to control the advantage of, by taking the advantage of AFO, so in those cases, if you keep the foot in 5 degrees plantar flexion, then that forces the knee to remain in extension. Thus, the patient is getting stability at the knee during normal locomotion. So that is one advantage.
So that means in a 95 degrees angle AFO, the foot, the knee is in 5 degrees plantar flexion, and in this case, we can again have the normal posture with the help of this type of AFO also. So now we'll move on to the next type of AFO, which is a lightweight AFO.
So see, there are different way of managing the foot and ankle with the help of ankle and foot orthosis in different indications. Like we have discussed, where is the knees in hyperextension or knees in buckling position. So similarly, we have got now different type of the ankle foot orthosis. We got different type of the ankle foot orthosis, which are now these days are high tech technologies being introduced to the field of prosthetic and orthotic itself. And earlier, the whatever that you have seen the AFOs that which the indigenous technology which we are using in our India itself. And in most of the countries, it is being used. But nowadays, high-tech technology is there available, which makes further the ankle-foot orthosis light in weight and gives some movement, slightly the movement at the ankle itself, some dorsiflexion or the plantar flexion movement is available with the springiness of the material. Material is slightly has a flexibility or the springiness over there. So it gives some type of the movement. It is very thin, very strong itself. It it's easily accommodated into the footwear itself, and it has got a technology which is being used in this fabrication, and it helps the users to feel free or feel like as a normal person. They don't look like they are using anything or they are, so nobody can notice that somebody is using any orthosis or not. So with the help of an orthosis, getting the treatment without giving an indication to anybody that whether somebody is using any orthosis or without an orthosis, the person is, looks like a normal person. So these are the lightweight AFOs that which we are available in India itself, or everywhere it is available. Indian government has given the free duty. There is no duty on these type of the appliances. One can get it freely. And these are easily available now in India with the many multinational companies. They are producing all this lightweight technology, or the high-tech technologies being introduced are available in Delhi, all metros, and even everywhere in India, wherever anybody wants, can get it. Ordering to the company or wherever they want, or through the net also, one can search it and can go for it.
Previously, actually, these are AFOs, all the AFOs are made out of metallic AFOs. It's made out of iron, metallic, and aluminum strips. These were used. And these were actually made of mechanical joints are made out of mild steel, and as well as stainless steel, as well as aluminum. And the design is actually, there are two bars are there. One is on the middle side, one is on the lateral side. And there is a socket in the bottom. And that socket is fixed to the normal footwear. The socket is fixed in the normal footwear, and the movements of the ankle is provided in the mechanical joint itself. You can provide all the movements what we have discussed earlier, and we can also give a fixed ankle also. And that is heavier in weight, and cosmetically this design is not acceptable to the patients actually. It's an odd design, and maintenance problems are also there. So that was known as a conventional ankle foot arthrosis, the old one actually. So now that design is complete, almost discarded. So still we are using these designs in paraplegic cases where there is no total contact to the body because the sensory loss is there. So there, this design still we are using. But otherwise, these designs are not acceptable for the patient's main point of view, the cosmetic point of view. And that is weight in heavy, and plus the manufacturing process, it takes a longer period. And there are maintenance problems are there due to all these problems. This design is rejected. And now the main design what we are using is that is high-tech design.